I think first of all, there's something that people don't say, but that is transpiring. People are afraid of eccentric bands.
Mm-hmm. My state of mind, we are on October 22nd. It's been exactly 2 years that we have started the project. And we're going to launch in November 10, which is approximately 19 days from now. And everything is fantastic. We are on time on every project that are being done in Switzerland. And we are terribly struggling for activities in the UK. And I'm smiling and I'm overwhelmed and I'm super stressed. The reality is this one, you know. Let's not lie to each other. It's incredible because on one side you see the beauty that is coming out. You see the fantastic job that everybody is doing. I mean, we are nobody. We're a very small brand. But you see how much people are passionate about the project. And on the other side, you realize how fragile is our startup and our business. Everything needs to be a show on November 10, and not everything is ready. So I don't know in what state I will be tomorrow.
My name is Estelle. I do like the fact that there are incredible people working for this kind of brand. It's just an amount of hours of work, very difficult. But I know that we are all belonging to this dream, actually, that I think it's the job that we all want to do right now, is to make it live again.
It's like a symphony. One person alone can't do much. So it's a symphony which is very important that everyone has to play together to make it a very nice sound. And then you find the right people. You need watchmaker, you need dial maker, you need case maker, you need strap maker, you need even good photographer, you need good PR people, you need everyone in the team who believe in the story and in the personality of Čapek.
So here is the place where we used to meet always to prepare the production of the dial. And here you can see on the back all the colors that they can create on enamel. So you see all the different tones. It's all handmade. Hi.
Hello. How are you, Xavier?
Good.
Good.
Dans des cadrans, on fabrique des cadrans, ce qu'on appelle les mailles grand feu. Mais la maille grand feu couvre un petit peu justement l'ensemble des travaux qui sont réalisés ici, mais spécialement sur les cadrans blancs qui sont réalisés de manière, en fait, comme il se faisait à l'authentique, c'est-à-dire que si on prend des montres, des anciennes montres qui datent de plus de 200 ans en arrière, les procédés utilisés ici sont exactement les mêmes sur une base de cuivre avec un émail déposé par saupoudrage. Donc c'est un composé de verre qu'on va mettre en fusion. On va travailler dans des températures supérieures à 600 degrés, environ 800 degrés. Et puis en fait, l'émail grand feu, c'est la fusion de poudre de verre. Cette opération-là, c'est une opération très délicate parce qu'on va faire la mise à plat du cadran. C'est qu'on a travaillé sur une surface qui est bombée tout le long. On a posé la décalque et puis on va mettre en fusion le cadran pour pouvoir venir appuyer avec un charbon puis faire la planité du cadran. Cette opération-là, elle nous prend environ 30 à 40% de déchets parce qu'on peut, si on a une occlusion qui vient se mettre sur le cadran, eh bien, on ne peut plus l'enlever. C'est-à-dire qu'on a une surface blanche qui est la plus belle possible avant de faire la décalque, mais dans l'opération, vu qu'on refond tout l'émail, eh bien, on peut avoir des occlusions qui ne seront pas enlevables. Opération délicate.
So we are here in California. Camille Fournet, it represents really the French heart of making leather goods adapted to the Swiss reality of making alligator straps.
Now we are at LAB. LAB is our supplier for the watch case, for the gold cases. And LAB belongs to the top suppliers you can have here in Switzerland. And we are very happy with them because creating our case was a very complicated process, and they have mastered it high excellence.
Okay, mon nom est Fabien Chapat, je suis le CEO des artisans boîtiers ici à La Chaux-de-Fonds. Naturellement, ben, les artisans boîtiers, c'est historiquement une société, on vient de fêter nos 15 ans d'activité au sein de la fondation de Famille Sandeau. Nous travaillons dans l'habillement, haute horlogerie, luxe, avec des pièces exceptionnelles. Nous, nous travaillons réellement pour toutes les plus grandes marques horlogères suisses.
Dans le domaine dont on exerce ici, le principe de polissage reste exactement le même. C'est toujours du travail manuel avec des disques coton, avec des feutres. Il n'y a rien du tout ici qui est industrialisé, donc on a exactement le même process qu'il y a 20-25 ans quand j'ai commencé.
Weber, they make excellent hands. You know, they live in a tiny village. They want to know the people first. When they saw the project, they say, wow, that's fantastic. And they pushed us to make the most beautiful hands we could make with them. And the last one I would speak about is Aurélien Boucher. And he's a crazy guy with a CEO, with a computer that creates anything that cannot be done.
Alors, Aurélien Boucher, vous êtes dans la maison AB Concept et AB Product. La partie production qui est composée de l'usinage, qui est notre premier métier, de la terminaison, polissage, satinage et autres, plus de du gravage laser, du soudage laser, du décolletage, du tournage CNC.
We needed to work on a collaborative way, and working in a collaborative way was meaning, okay, we are naked, we are what we are as good as we can, but we have a vision. Creating an extraordinary product, and they never have that. What the other brands are telling them is, you're too expensive for what you do, you don't respect my design, so now please respect perfectly my design, stop interpreting and make a better price. And so it's very frustrating work for craftsmen. They need to express their talent. So what we did basically was to give them the key of the car and say, drive where you want, this is the vision, this is where we want to go. So don't go away from that vision, but choose the way we want to go there. That was the first time for some of them who had worked 20 or 30 years in the industry. Sometimes people could say, you know, collaboration and luxury, how do you really balance the two? It's all a question of vision. If you cut corners, you will never get to luxury. If you stop looking at that level and start looking at a more commercial level, you will lose the luxury level. Now a lot of people are tired of big brands, big luxury brands that are everywhere. And that's where the startup can come in. So right now we are in Place Vendôme, in the center of Paris. Paris is famous for art de vivre, for haute joaillerie, and for being the sort of essence and the place where luxury was born and was grown as an industry. So Chapek was first in Geneva, and then with the rise of success, he decided to open first a store here in Paris, Place Vendôme. He had a store on number 23, which is exactly here, where Cartier has now the whole building. And he has a store on number 25. And our belief is that it was, the Chapek store was the first watchmaking boutique in Place Vendôme. So I went here, it's like a little pilgrimage, not to see where it is and to see how it looks like. But my real reason to come to Paris was to meet a very important person in the world of watchmaking. He's working on Rue Saint-Honoré. He owns a shop which is called Chronopassion. And this man called Laurent Picciotto is a real genius at finding new projects, new stories. And now we just saw each other today, and he has confirmed that he's going to retail the products. So he is our first partner worldwide. Chrono Passion, Rue Saint-Honoré, Paris. Today we are November 2nd. We are launching the brand on November 10, which means that we are day minus 9. And I'm counting the days every day. And my state of mind is in between the pleasure, the joy of seeing the things coming out and seeing it happening. And at the same time, the stress of not having enough time to do everything.